So there is a program and display the product of 10 even numbers. So this is a program to find out 10 even numbers. Here we will introduce a concept of looping. So let us first understand the program, how it works. First we will start the program, then we have variable numeric number, product and n even, three variables we are having here. In n number it is a process, and n number have the value of 2, n even as the value of 0, n product as the value of 1. So first is does, flow lines begins. The first process is n product equal to n number multiplied by n product. So in n product we will put the value n number multiplied by n product. You can see n number is 2 and n product is 1. So 2 multiplied by 1 equal to 2. Now n product having value of 2. Then in n number we are storing n number plus 2. So n number having the value of 2 plus 2 means there is an increment of 2 there. So 2 converted into 4 now. Same as in n even, n even plus 1. So n even was 0 plus 1, 1. Now n number as 4 and n even as 2. Now it is checking, is n even greater than 10? If it is yes, now n even is having the value of 1, and here is it checking the if n even is greater than 10, so the result is false. So less than 10, so the result is true. Then the flow goes to the beginning of that program again. Then we will convert the value n number multiplied by n product. So n product was having the value of 2 and n number was the value of 4. So 4 into 2 equal to 8. Now n product is 8 and n number equal to n number plus 2. So n number earlier was having the value of 4 plus 2, 6. N even having the value of 1 plus 1, 2. So basically every time the programs runs from this side, it stores a number here in n even. The condition is the until n even is less than 10, till the programs return true and it moves in a loop. But when the condition when it is incremented to 10, then it will go in no and display n product and then stop. Okay. So now let's try this program. So first we have to start. So we will start this program sub and ABC. Any name of this macro? Then first one was storing variable n numeric. Numeric mein, in numeric n number, n product, n even. So dim n number, n product and n even. We can declare the values in one go also, separated by comma, as integer. So here we have three variables, n number, n product, n even of integer. Okay.
What is integer? You told something, but I actually forgot that integer is a.
I introduce only two variables here. One is numeric, second is character. Character is for displaying text only, alphanumerics, and numeric is for calculation only. Okay.
Okay.
So we have to do some calculations. So we will we will take integer here. Second is step is storing values, n number equal to 2, n 1 equal to 0, n product equal to 1. So here we will give.
So always the numbers, then we have to take as an integer.
Yes, sir. So n number is having the value of 2. Then we have n product equal to 1, and n even is equal to 0. Okay. Then here the loop starts. So in this, there are 2-3 types of loop. When I will be reaching at this level, I will tell you how to operate that loops. So first, this loop is called do while loop, where the instruction given first, condition given at last. So here we will use do while loop. So here we will type do. Between we will take instruction, and here in while we will give condition. Okay, so condition is n even less than 10. So we will type condition n even less than 10. So this is a condition. In between we have to give the instructions. So in n product equal to n number multiplied by n product, n number multiplied by n product. Then we have n number equal to n number plus 2, n number equal to n number plus 2. Then we have n even equal to n even plus 1, n even equal to n even plus 1. These two things I am doing, it is called in programming language increment. Increment, we do increment or decrement. We increase the value of same variable and we decrease the value of same variable. We usually use this increment only in loops. Okay. Then we have condition, and after the condition, when it happens, it moves to next. Display n product. So I will do msg box in which I will give n product. Okay, so in msg box I have supplied n product. So let's run the macro. We have to do end while here. Let's see the procedure of do while in because syntax mistake can be there. So do while in VBA. Let's see the syntax of that. So it would be easy to create. Do loop condition. Okay. Do loop. Then we have this product. Do I like until? Do until, not do while, until. So until it's returned true, it will be multiplying the number. Let's we have a dry run table in that for three variables. Let's see the stepwise calculation of that. For that we will use watch window so that we can understand.
No, what? Sorry, Sandeep ji. What until has done? It's showing as a 2, right?
Yes. For that, let us see this event, because what it is actually doing, we can understand why it is showing 2. Okay, so for a stepwise running, we use F8. So where the yellow line goes, I just add some values, add watch. We can add variables here. Expression is n number. First expression is n number. Second, I add watch on n product. Third, I add watch in n even. So basic the value, what values they are having, it is showing me here. Now we just press F8. Now everything is running here. N even is incrementing in a hurry, actually. I think here we have n number 2, n even 0. Then we go in loop, n product is having the value of 2, number multiplied by 2 into 1 is 2. Okay, n number should be 2 plus 2 4, it is 4. Now n even should be of 1. Okay, n even is equal to 1 and is okay. So here is the problem. We will put while loop here. Loop, I will make you understand in our loop section. First, I just want to show what's actually happening here. So we will move on. Now n product is having value of 8, n even its value having the value of 2. So while it is n even is less than 10, it will be keep moving the values, keep multiplying the values. We are displaying n product here, and in every increment you can see the n product's value here. See, every time it's changing. N even is now 6, till we go to 9, and when we reach to 10, when this condition returns false, it exits the loop. Okay, now n product is this having the value of this one, and the message display the same value. Okay, so basically it is a procedure, it is a concept. I'm just giving you a brief of that programming concept so that we can understand how it is planned before programming. Okay, how we represent the data. So you understand how it worked.
Yeah.
Looping, you understand? On the basis of one on the basis of one condition, we just move our values.
Yeah.
Now let's have a look of another example. In this program, count the number of odd and even numbers. Till what? Till 50. What the program is doing? Start numeric, it has 4 variables, n number, n odd, n even, n counter. Okay, n counter is for how long this process will be running. So first we take value n counter as 1, n odd for calculating odd values, n even for calculating even values. So first is takes the entry from user, because it's a input sign, so it's taking an entry from user. Then is n number, this operator I have told you modulo. Okay, that means remainder. When I have inserted a number as 10 and I check the remainder from 2, if it is 0 it will go to yes and increase the even part, and if there is a remainder then it will increase the odd part, because either number can be even or can be odd. Okay, so yeah. it is separately counting any even numbers and odd numbers in this process, and then it moves to next, and n counter increases the value of 1. Okay, so even and odd separately counting the values, and n counter is just counting the values that how much numbers user have entered. So in next condition there is n counter greater than less than equal to 50. So till the condition do not exceed to this one, it will be keep running, and it will accept 50 values from user, and it will calculate the even numbers and odd numbers, and on the basis of counter it will know that how much values he has entered, and after that it is display odd numbers, display even numbers. Okay, so let us do it with five values, the same condition. So in same module I create different sub procedure as sub counter. Okay, then what I supposed to do in process, n numeric, n in numeric I will take n number, n odd, n even, n counter. So dim n numeric, n even, n odd, n counter as integer. Then it is supplying the value n counter as 1, n counter as 1, then n odd equal to 0 and n even equal to 0. Then we have our loop here. We can understand this as a loop, and there is a condition that we will apply this condition through if else if condition. So the loop procedure is same as we have put here, do loop while. So we will apply our loop here, do loop while. What is the condition? N counter greater less than equal to 50. N counter less than equal to, I said 5 numbers we will take. Okay. Then in between I have to do coding of this except number 1, except n number. So we will do n number, and for taking entry from user we have to use input box. In input box I will show a message, enter the number. Okay, this thing, the value I get from user will be stored in n number. Then a condition that checks is number modulo by 2 equal to 0. So I will apply my if function. In if I have to give condition n number mod. Mod is an operator for this sign modulo, mod 2 equal to 0, then we have two parts here, else this is the and if. This is the proper procedure of putting if condition here. When this condition is true, it will run the this section of code, and when it is false it will run this section of code, and this is the end. This is your if condition procedure. So syntax will be the same. Then how I will put the yes part. Yes, n even equal to n even plus 1. I will put n even equal to n even plus 1, and in no part means false part, n odd equal to n odd plus 1. Okay, then we escape from this condition. Now n counter equal to n counter plus 1. So outside I will type n counter equal to n counter plus 1. Okay, then we have condition for loop and we have applied that. Then we will display the result, display n odd, display n even. So I will do message box and I will show the message even equal to concatenate that n even, a value in n even will be shown here, and I apply some space here, odd equal to n sign and n odd. Okay, so
what is that actually? You gave some
we have learned some concatenation operator.
Okay.
okay. So concatenation we have use AND actually. Suppose that I put this criteria in Excel here. Okay. Now here I type some even values, here I type some odd values. So I put equal to here for starting any formula, and even I will give the reference. It the variable also work as reference here. Okay, then an odd, it is like this. So let's see what formula returns. Okay, for displaying this message I'm using these keywords. The AND basically concatenates, joined the values.
Okay. Yeah.
So let us run the program first. It asks me number. I enter one. I have to enter some 5 numbers here, and it will tell me how many was even and how much was odd. Okay. So you understand this, how this program worked?
Yeah.
Basically we are studying PLT just to understand the programming concepts.
Yeah.
That's how we are working. After that I will connect you to the range system, range sheets. This is a address cell. I will connect you to cell, sheets, workbooks, and other application objects such as Word, PowerPoint, Outlook. So charts, pivot tables, conditional formatting, filter.
Yeah.
So I will do my way like this. But the concept, the calculation concept will be the same, like we are applying
okay,
here.
Okay.
First we have to design a program that what is to be made. Let's understand another program. Count the number of odd and even numbers. Oh, we have done this. Display the highest of any 10 numbers. Earlier we have done highest of 3 numbers by if else. Now let's see, if we have 10 numbers, in 10 values we need to identify which one is the highest. So this is the program for that. Start numerics, we have 3 integers, number, n number, n largest, n counter. Counter is just helping the loop for running. Okay, now accept numbers, it is giving it is accepting the numbers from user. Then is n number greater than n largest? So currently the largest is having the value of 0, so n number is greater, so we will move in yes. Then in n largest it will store the value of n number, then it moves n counter, take increment of 1, then it checks is n counter less than 10, then again it runs. Now every time when it checks, when it will find the largest value in n number to the previous number, it will store in n largest, otherwise it will skip that code. Okay, so let us make this program. Sub, I will give the name of this program XYZ. In XYZ First, I have to declare the value. N number, n largest, n counter. N number. The name you can provide any. You can give like ABC also. But this type of naming concept helps you to understand the variables. Because when the program is lengthy, it is difficult to identify how your variable working. And for why
DAM means it's a definition, right? What is the meaning of DAM? Dimension or?
It's just a code. It is just a syntax for starting.
Okay.
So there are a lot of keywords which don't have any meaning. So DIM is just, but if it is a language, there will be any thing like what DIM means in VBA. Definition, correct. DIM means the definitions. Let's see. Declare, allocate storage space for one or more variables. And what is the meaning of DIM?
Defining the variable, I think. Yeah, okay. Okay, whatever it is, okay.
Defining variable. What does it stand for? Actually, they don't have any meaning. It is a complicated question. Nobody thinks about it.
Okay, no issues.
Okay. Then we have value n counter 0 and largest 0. N counter equal to 0 and largest equal to 0. Then we have a loop system here. Okay, so what is the condition? It will go in our do loop while condition. We can give if n counter let's say we will choose the highest value in 5 values. Okay, because 10 times I have to give the numbers, that's why I have chosen 5. I don't want to enter 10 times. So 5. Now the instruction is accept the n number. So n number, same procedure is here. N number equal to input box, enter the number. Then we have n number is greater than n largest. Now this is an if statement condition. It's not looping, it is a if statement, and in no case it skips the way of if. So we do not need to give here the false part because it is moving ahead. So in our if statement we will give only a single condition, n number greater than n largest, then we need to put an end to this ending, and we have to do only one condition here, n largest. If the n number is greater than n largest, then what we have to do, we have to assign the value of n number to n largest. Okay.
Yeah.
Then just skip, because there is a no definition for no part. It's just moving around. N counter equal to n counter plus 1. This is for loop increment, n counter equal to n count काउंटर प्लस वन एंड देन डिस्प्ले एंड लार्जेस्ट मैसेज बॉक्स एंड लार्जेस्ट. ओके नाउ लेट्स रन द प्रोग्राम फ्रॉम हियर. So it is the largest number, largest of 5. You can also create a dry run table for that, because every time we are just creating the program here, so what should be the output we can draw in Excel itself. And how it will be drawn, I just tell you. We have to just keep an eye on these variables, n number, n largest, n counter, n number, n largest, n counter. Okay, so first it has 0, 0 value, 0, 0. And it is also a zero before loop. So when the loop runs first time, then what happens? It takes the number which enters into n number. Let us see, there is 25. Okay, then in it is checking n number, is n number is greater than n largest. So we will just apply a condition here. If n number is greater than n largest, okay, then what should it do? If it is greater, then pick this one. If it is not, then pick the earlier one. Okay, so this is a program. Then in n counter is always plus 1 in that. Okay, so I will keep running this program up to 5 numbers, and I just drag these formulas down and type the numbers here. So n largest having the largest number. See, in the last I am displaying the result. That's how the program works. This is the core concept of programming.
Okay.
Okay, when we give the maximum number here, it will change to this one. Any value exceeds to that, it will take that greater one. Okay, so that's how we create our dry run table. This concept is called dry run table. In Excel it is very easy, because we can create this with our formula. And if you are using paper and pen, you just apply the condition by your mind and write the values. It is a great way for cross-checking. Then after knowing the programming concept, after knowing variables and if statements, loops, we just know the modular programming. Why we do modular programming? Because we just break the program into small parts. Or suppose I am creating a program for service tax, and the service tax program I need to give in my program several times. So what I will do, I will create a program named as, such as you can see, there is a divide. That means a module for divide I will create here. Okay. Now let's see what is it's actually doing. I have two modules for multiply and for divide. We have different programs, and then we start numeric. We have n choice display 1 multiply 2 divide. It is displaying to user if you want to whether you want to multiply or divide. Give your answer in 1 or 2. Display enter choice. Choice either you enter 1 or 2. So accept n choice. We have accepted that what the user has entered here. When then we have condition here. Is n choice is equal to 1? So 1 refers for multiply. So if yes, then we will switch to multiply. And if no, if n choice is 2, then it will refer to divide. If it is no, it will end the program. So when it refers to multiply, it just it will just jump into this one, this section, and it will create this processing. N numeric, num1, num2, num3, n product. Okay, four variables are here. 1, 2, 3, three numbers being accepted by user. Then product of three numbers in n product. Then display n product. But if he has chosen divide, then it will jumped into divide module, and it will have num1, num2. Two numbers will be accepted by user. Then is num2 is equal to 0? If yes, it will display denominator cannot be 0. Okay. If no, it will divide. Display n num1 divide by n num2. So it's a simple calculation, and then return. Returns means it will return to this point again, and then it flows with flow line. Okay.
Yeah.
So that's how this program work. Let me give you the example of this thing. So what we are actually doing here, we are just creating different modules here.
Yeah.
Okay, so insert module. In modules, we can do by two things. Modular programming, we can use modules also. We can, there is a sub level of this module. This is procedures. One procedure is there, second procedure is there. In between any module, we can refer any of the thing, such as I have sub procedure named B. When I type counter, then it will run the counter program, this counter. So when I run this, it will run the counter. Okay, so it refers to this whole program when I just type the name only. Let's see how it is working. I press F8, goes to counter, then this, it will run fully. Displayed message, return to this one. Okay. So that's, this is basically modular programming. Now if I have to use this function again and again, I can type many times this thing. I can use my all programs in that, such as ABC. Okay. So there will be, there two program will run there. First program is over, then second program. Here it is. Okay. So we can use these options very powerfully. So from tomorrow we will do real programming with Excel.
Which one?
Real program with Excel.
Okay.
So hope you understand the concept that how we will do.
Yeah.
Then there are questions, you can read that and try to solve it, or if try to read all things, because it is the same. Yeah. Try to understand this then, because it will increase only your logical abilities.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
These are
all questions.
Yeah, these are off-page connectors, which is no use in Excel programming. When you are doing on paper, you are creating a book, then it refers to that off-page connectors.
Yeah, helpful for us. Yes.
On-page connectors are this one, which joined in the same page. Okay. The end.
Sorry.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Now.
I have one question, 2 minutes from you.
Yes, sir.
Today I'm just trying to just Google some VBA program. Actually, I have 5 or 6 sheets.
Okay.
Each sheet is having name like, say, sheet 1, 2, 3, 4, like that, presuming that way.
Yes, sir.
And this was saved in the C drive.
Okay.
What happened is, each and every time